The video is Le'ila Nishmas of Shmuel Baruch and Chaim Tzedov Gedech of Shabbos back in Muncie. You know, we asked Reb Chaim, what is the main mitzvah that B'nei Chutzal should be focused on here in exile? What should we be focused on? He said, as I said, Ma Ikar Avdal B'nei Chutzal, he said, Lavol Eretz Yisrael, to come back to Eretz Yisrael. So we should be zeichet to come back to Eretz Yisrael. But in the meantime, the good thing is that our quest, our journey to figure out what it means to be in love with the Rebbein Shem, to be Davik in the Rebbein Shem, we spoke to tzaddikim, and they all gave us different paths, which is in itself amazing. Why? Because really it's not a contradiction. Once you know the definition, Dveikus means to be close to Hashem, to have a relationship with Hashem. The option of Rebbe said, no, Dveikus means something you just can't stop. The Talmud Rebbe said so beautiful, he said, you know what it's like a football game. He meant soccer. Football games, or the same thing. Especially in America, you could be in a football game, it's snowing, it's raining, it doesn't matter. You're not thinking about it. Look at the fans. We have to be fans of the Rebbein Shalom. So my friend Rabbi Yoina, after thanking himself, Shlomo Kalbach once told him, he said, you know, Shlomo Kalbach said, he said, you cannot know what it means to love Hashem until you're in love with the lady. And really, that's Shir Hashir. That's what we said, Dovak V'Yishtoi. It's a relationship. How to get there? It's different paths. Some have the ability to get to Tveikus, to have sense of Rebbein Shalom through speaking to Rebbein Shalom, through davening to Rebbein Shalom, through mitzvahs, through Torah. 4 hours of learning straight, 3 hours of learning straight. Today, probably Hashem has a chesed, it's only 2 hours less. That's already a miracle. That is what Tveikus, and we got that incredible journey. But listen to this amazing matana. There's in during the week, you could learn choik. There's a sefer called choik, it's a beautiful thing, and it has all the different parts, Mishnah, Gemara, and also has Zohar. So I learned my father. Pink Thursday, yesterday, Rebbein Shem gave us a matana. Zok de Zohar HaKadosh, and there's the pearls of Zohar in this week's parash, but I want to focus on the last one. The Zohar HaKadosh says, look, Klal Yisrael want to be Dovik. This is the Lashon of the Zohar. Klal Yisrael want to be Dovik to the Rebbein Shem. Hashem knows we want to be close to him. And sometimes he has to send us dinim, he has to send us punishments. It looks like punishments, but really it's just because he loves us. So he sends us negoyim, he sends us tzaras in the houses, nega tzaras, right, in the houses. Why? Because there's pearls there, but not just pearls. Zok the Zohar HaKadosh, the kasha, the sfasemus, and everyone asks, wait a minute, you just can't give us the pearls, the money, you have to destroy the house in order to get it? No, the house was built because with the wrong intentions. Koyach of tumah, the koyach. What does that mean, tumah? Tumah means when you don't have a direct direction in the Rebbein Shem, when there's a disconnect. Impurity doesn't mean something bad, disgusting, dirty. It means that there's just no connection, there's no Wi-Fi. Spiritual Wi-Fi, the Rebbein Shem says, listen, I'm going to clean up the Wi-Fi and I'll make sure you have insurance, you can rebuild the house. But Zok de Zohar HaKadosh is because we want to be davek to the Rebbein Shem, so the Rebbein Shem sends us matanas, and that's what we need to do. We need to speak to Rebbein Shem and say, Rebbein Shem, I want to get close. I want to experience what this, what Tzaddikim is speaking, are telling us what the Dveikus is. And we have to remember what Ishra Meir Morgenstern said. Even a little bit of emunah, just believing in the Rebbein Shem, which is being said in the Baal Shem, that's also Dveikus. And that should give us amazing chizuk. We're going into the Shabbos of Ischachus, of Parshas Chodesh Nisan. Some have a minute to have three kugels because of three Sefer Torah. If kugel gets you closer to the Rebbein Shem, as long as you're following the directions of Chazal, of the Torah, how to get close to the Rebbein Shem, you're on the right path. And if you believe, if you started just believing in the Rebbein Shem, loving the Rebbein Shem, just remember one thing, the love, the definition of love means the emotional pleasure you experience when you focus on someone's virtues, when you focus on someone's positive attributes, and that's what it means to love Hashem. To love Hashem means that, yes, it is difficult, but the Torah tells us that the Rebbein Shem loves us. That's how we started this whole quest. We say, how do you know Rebbein Shem loves you? Because the Torah says he loves you. And not just the Torah says, you could look outside into the world of kindness. Teva, by nature, is beautiful. It's when there's a storm, when there's something destructive, we say, whoa, where's the Rebbein Shem? Chas v'shalom, when there's a Holocaust, and there's things that are out of order, but etzer b'teva, one thing that's positive about teva is the fact that the Rebbein Shem created a world of kindliness. As Avigdor Melech Zichrono Livracha says, always focus on an apple, appreciate the trees, appreciate the air, appreciate human beings, fascinating. And that's how you get to, like the Rambam says, to be misboinen. Look at creation, look at human beings, just alone, how complicated and fascinating they are. Yeah, sometimes it's difficult. You know, the human beings are so easy to love, and the human beings are much more difficult. But by the Rebbein Shem has so many positive things. Of course, everything is positive, but sometimes it's difficult, and you have to be real with that. And if the Rebbein Shem, I want to love you, I want to get closer to you, help us. Have an amazing Shabbos.